Today we're going to look at clique complexes, a special type of abstract simplicial complex, which itself we can view as a type of hypergraph. A clique complex of an undirected graph G, denoted by X of G, is an abstract simplicial complex whose vertices are the vertices of G, and whose faces are the non-empty cliques of G. Note that because every subset of a clique is itself a clique, and the singleton sets containing each vertex in a graph are each one cliques, X of G satisfies all the requirements of an abstract simplicial complex. As an example, if we have this graph G, what is its clique complex? Its cliques are 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 2, 3, 1, 3, 1, 2, 3, and 4, 5, 4, and 5. So those will be the faces of our clique complex. And the vertices are the vertices of the graph. So this is our clique complex. Now, it's important to note that not every abstract simplicial complex is the clique complex of some graph. As an example, the abstract simplicial complex with the following faces and vertices cannot be the clique complex of any graph, because if we have a graph on the vertices 1, 2, and 3, our complex being a clique complex of some graph on these vertices would imply that in that graph, 1, 2 is a clique, 1, 3 is a clique, and 2, 3 is a clique, which together would mean that 1, 2, 3 is a clique in the graph. Yet 1, 2, 3 is not a face in our complex, meaning our complex cannot be a clique complex. This might remind you of the counterexamples that show that not all hypergraphs are conformal hypergraphs. This leads us to our next point. If we consider abstract simplicial complexes to be hypergraphs whose edges are closed under taking subsets, then the clique complex of a graph is just a conformal hypergraph whose two-section is that graph. Specifically, the conformal hypergraph whose two-section is our graph and whose edges are closed under taking subsets. In other words, if a complex is a clique complex, it must be the clique complex of its two-section, which means that it must be a conformal hypergraph. However, the other direction might not be true. Here's an example of a conformal hypergraph that is not the clique complex of its two-section. It fails to be a clique complex because it's not an abstract simplicial complex at all. Its edges are not closed under taking subsets. Now, any conformal hypergraph that's downward closed must be a clique complex. Specifically, it's the clique complex of its two-section. This is because if a hypergraph is conformal, it has no isolated vertices. And if a hypergraph's edges are downward closed, then all singletons are edges, meaning the hypergraph satisfies both requirements to be an abstract simplicial complex. And in addition, if it's conformal, then all the maximal cliques of the two-section are maximal by inclusion edges of the hypergraph, which together with the downward closure of edges means that the rest of the edges of the hypergraph are the rest of the cliques of its two-section. Basically, conformal hypergraphs can only fail to be clique complexes if they also fail to be abstract simplicial complexes at all. And there's only one way for that to happen. Its edges are not closed under taking subsets. Coming back to our hypergraph perspective, we can write the following. A complex is a clique complex if and only if it's a conformal hypergraph whose edges are closed under taking non-empty subsets. Additionally, if we take any hypergraph without isolated vertices that's not conformal, and then make that hypergraph's edges closed under taking subsets, then while the result is an abstract simplicial complex, the resulting complex can't be the clique complex of any graph. This is because by construction, such a hypergraph would be a complex that's not conformal. Moving on, let's look at some of the characteristics of clique complexes. The facets of a clique complex, C, of a graph G, are the maximal cliques of G, and the dimension of C will be one less than the clique number of G. A subcomplex of C will not necessarily be a clique complex, as we discussed before that not all complexes are clique complexes. All that's necessary to form a subcomplex that's not a clique complex is to choose some facet of our clique complex, and then form a subcomplex from just the faces of that facet, not including the facet itself. The result is a subcomplex of C, but it cannot be the clique complex of a graph because it's not a conformal hypergraph. It's missing a maximal clique of its two section as an edge. There's a whole class of subcomplexes that will not be clique complexes. These are the K skeletons of the clique complex, for K less than the dimension of the clique complex and greater than zero. This is because the two section of the K skeleton will be the same as the two section of the entire complex, but for K less than the dimension of the complex, we'll be missing some of the faces in the original clique complex of dimension larger than K, meaning there will be some maximal clique in the 2 section that's not a face of the K skeleton. Next, let's examine the concept of a link in a clique complex. To review, a link of a face F in a complex C is the subcomplex whose faces satisfy two properties. Their intersection with F must be empty, and their union with F must be another face in the complex. In my previous video, we talked about one way to find the link of a face. For each facet M that contains our face F, find the set of vertices that, when added to F, give us M, and then find the set of all faces involving just those vertices. Repeat this process for each maximal face that contains F, and you'll get the link by taking the union of all the faces that we find. So, from the perspective of clique complexes, the link of a certain clique C is the set of all cliques in G that complete a clique when added to C, but do not share any vertices with clique C. If we wanted to find a link of a clique C using the method we just described for abstract simplicial complexes, we could first find the maximal cliques that contain C, and then for each of these maximal cliques, we would find the set of all cliques formed just from the vertices in the maximal clique that are not in C. The union of these sets would be the link of C. As an example, what's the link of face 1, 2 in the clique complex of our graph? Well, in our graph, the maximal cliques that contain 1, 2 are 1, 2, 3, 4, and 1, 2, 5, 6. The set of vertices in 1, 2, 3, 4 that are not in 1, 2 is 3, 4. The set of cliques that we can form using only the vertices in this set are 3, 4, 3, and 4. The set of vertices in 1, 2, 5, 6 that are not in 1, 2 is 5, 6. And the set of cliques that we can form using only those vertices are 5, 6, 5, and 6. Taking the union of these two sets, we get our link. This is the set of cliques that don't share any vertices with 1, 2, but complete a clique in the graph when we take the union with 1, 2. To finish the video, let's look at another kind of complex that we can build from an undirected graph, closely related to the clique complex. That is the independence complex. The independence complex of a graph G is a complex whose vertices are the vertices of G, and whose faces are the non-empty independent sets of G. Note that the independence complex of G is really just a clique complex of the complement of G, as the non-empty independent sets of G are the non-empty cliques of the complement of G. As an exercise, let's find the independence complex of the following graph. The independent sets in this graph are as follows. So those will be the faces of our independence complex. And the vertices of the independence complex will be the vertex set of our graph. That's our result. I encourage you to take the complement of our graph and then find the clique complex and verify that it's the same abstract simplicial complex as the independence complex of our graph. That's it for this video. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, please subscribe and click the like button. Have a great day.